It's the National Football League on EA Sports, where we'll see teams who have been division rivals since 1961. It's the Philadelphia Eagles and the Dallas Cowboys, under the lights on Sunday night.
We are sandwiched between Fort Worth and Dallas, Texas, in Arlington at the luxurious AT&T Stadium. Tonight, we've got a great Sunday night matchup on tap, as it'll be the defending NFC champions, the Philadelphia Eagles, taking on the Dallas Cowboys. Alongside Charles Davis, I'm Brandon Gauden. And Charles, here in Dallas, winning isn't everything. It's the only thing. But this team this year may have even extra pressure on their shoulders in what might very well be the toughest division in football.
And that extra pressure will go on the offensive side of the ball. They'll need consistent play from the quarterback position because they are very explosive. And on the defensive side, they want to continue to take the ball away and make themselves contenders in the NFC East.
But meanwhile, for the Eagles, the big question, how would they improve their squad in 2023 and make another run at a Super Bowl title? Well, they took a few hits in free agency, but by most accounts, really hit a home run during April's draft. You were there. What did you make of it?
It was almost a night beyond their wildest dreams. Perhaps the best player in the draft somehow fell to 9, where the Eagles traded up to get him. And a terrific pass rusher they got at 30. Wonderful draft, extra pieces for a Super Bowl contender.
The kickoff team on the field now as they will send this one away. And he'll take it up past the 25 to the 26-yard line. So here are the Cowboys now ready to go on offense for the first time. And trotting out there, a guy who's established himself as a veteran in this league, now in his fifth year at quarterback.
This guy's leadership is so important to how this offense functions. He doesn't shrink from any moments on game day, and everything he does with confidence. He sets the example in practice, off the field, and is the guy leading everyone out for each possession.
They'll start on the ground with Barber, and he can only manage to get a couple. Second and 8 coming up.
Well, any lane that might have been open there was closed pretty quickly, and that was because the defensive front, they won that battle at the point of attack at the line of scrimmage. They used great leverage, held their spot, and stacked him up.
Here's Romo now on second down. And this is caught by Witten, the tight end. And he is going to lose yardage here. Call it a loss of 2 there on the play. And that brings up 3rd and a full 10 yards.
We'll put that one in the win column for the defense. Trying to contain tight ends in the passing game is so difficult nowadays, but they did in a big way there.
Throwing on 3rd down, Romo. He's going to float this one deep right side. Inside the 10. They're able to convert on 3rd down, and that sets up a 1st and goal.
Oh my goodness, I'll tell you what, 3rd down, all you're thinking is, what can we do to keep this drive going to get enough yardage to move the sticks? You're certainly not thinking about taking this one almost the length of the field, but that's exactly what happens here. What a play, and what a change of fortunes.
A terrific opening drive has them knocking on the door, 1st and goal. From the gun, here's Romo. Looking in zone, but it's incomplete.
Whenever I see a drop like that, I have to kind of take a step back and check myself a little bit. So used to seeing those big guys make big-time spectacular plays that when they drop one, I have to remind myself, we ask a lot out of these guys. Block and catch the football. Not easily done in today's NFL.
On 2nd down, Barber. And he'll be stopped just outside the 5 at the 6. Only a couple yards there, and that's going to set up a long 3rd and goal. Defensively, I think they can smell a stop ball right around the 5 here, brings up 3rd.
And I think what they've done is they put doubt in the minds of the offensive guys. What do we do? Because now you don't have a go-to play. Either side they pick, throwing it, running it, it won't be easy.
And that is incomplete, but a penalty flag coming in. This could be a first down.
So pass interference to call. That's going to set him up with a first down.
And if it's a bang-bang play, maybe the flag stays in the official's pocket, but instead, he definitely impeded the receiver's right to catch the football. The official's letting the players know how the...
And he'll get in! Touchdown, Cowboys! 1 yard touchdown run, and the Cowboys will claim the early lead as they're on the board first here tonight.
Everybody in the stadium knew what they were going to do right there, CD. Three tight ends on the field, all that extra bulk, and they run it in.
And you saw where that one went, right? You run it over your best blocker. I can just see the head coach right now. I want to run this one over the big boy. And they got it done.
Point after, right down the middle. And it's now a 7-0 game. So the drive there took 6 plays. And it's capped off for the Cowboys touchdown. The kickoff unit is out on the field, and they will send this one away. And he won't return this one. He'll go down to a knee, and they'll start at the 25. So now here comes the Eagles offense as they get ready to take over. And they'll be led out by their 6-year quarterback.
His ability to adjust on the fly is almost unmatched in the game right now because it leads to a couple of snaps per game where you just sit back and ask yourself, how did he pull that off? Opponents can practice and prepare each and every week all they want, but this guy, he is hard to corral.
Now a first down throw, McNabb. This will be caught by Brown. And he's taken down, but able to slip across the 35. The drive starting with a first down, 11 yards on that pickup.
Defense gives up a touchdown on the opening drive. Offense, you got to want to get out there and get those points back right now.
And that's a sharp throw there to get this drive off to a good start. So from the 36 now, first and 10.
And down he goes at the 45 after a pickup of 9.
A nice run here early on. It doesn't take a great play caller to realize you want to establish a guy of his caliber with runs like this early, because they will pay dividends as the game progresses.
Second down and a little more than a yard here.
They'll keep it on the ground. Westbrook. And he'll get it out to midfield. Looks like, yeah, they'll spot it right at midfield at the 50. A gain of 5, good enough for the first down. Couple of nice carries back-to-back here, establishing the ground game a bit.
Yeah, these aren't bare-bones runs now. I mean, they're getting substantial yardage, the kind of yards you're looking for, right? Let's go ahead and use a cliche. Stay ahead of the change, right? Five or more yards each time, that's what you're looking for in setting a tone and getting your offensive line going.
Good sign on the opening drive. On first down, they look downfield, and it's complete. Touchdown, Philadelphia! A big play there! 50 yards! And the Eagles are able to match the opening drive touchdown against them with one of their own. As a former DB, you might not like to see that, but from a wide receiver's perspective, those are the plays they dream of.
Correct on both counts, all right? Because once he took off, I mean, let's face it, that should have been done in Big Sky Country. Aren't any speed limits out there? And off he went. Glad I wasn't the one trying to chase him.
Extra point right down the middle, and we are tied at 7. The drive summary, 4 plays, 75 yards, and it was capped off by an Eagles touchdown. Each team's had it. Each team has scored. 7-7 here as the kick's away.
And not much happening on the return as he'll get this to about the 23.
Second drive forthcoming here for the Dallas Cowboys. And that last drive, so effective in the passing game, resulting in the touchdown. Maybe not many people were focused on the trenches. There was good protection there.
Excellent protection. So now, defensively, you've almost got to get down into those starters' blocks like you're a sprinter. Get lower than those guys on offense and find a way to roar through them or around them to get into the face of the passer.
Easier said than done, though.
Way easier said than done. But they've got to try something because right now, they're just cutting them to shreds.
And he's going to get this one across the 30-yard line. Give him 10 yards there, and about by the nose of the football, he's going to have a first down.
I know this may be jumping the gun a little bit, but 7-7, they're flinging it around like crazy. Look at the drive that's going on here. Partner, we may have to start thinking about one of these defenses just holding someone to a field goal and maybe trying to get an advantage that way.
Now here's a pass on first down that's knocked away and incomplete.
Well, anytime he reads man coverage, I don't think it's going to be the only time he'll try and hit that route to the outside in this game. He'll test the perimeter, but that time, they were up to the challenge.
Second and 10 from the 33-yard line. An inside give to Jones.
And he'll be stopped at about the 38 after a pickup of four.
Typically, we think it's the strong safeties that are better tacklers, especially closer to the line of scrimmage amidst traffic. But in this case, how about the free safety coming up and making the big-time play?
The Eagles call on the extra defensive back here as they prepare for a stop on third down. Now Romo. Oh, he had him. He was open, but he couldn't get it to him. It's incomplete.
Now that's a good bounce back after giving up a touchdown on the opening drive. Just one first down permitted and then out. Obviously no loss of confidence with that defense, and now they get to turn it back to their offense.
Out now comes the Cowboys punter as he's on to punt for the first time tonight. And this one hits at the three and then bounds into the end zone for a touchback. So back onto the field, here come the Eagles for their second drive.
This drive here beginning probably with a pair of motivated groups. Remember, the offense scored a touchdown on their last time out, looking to repeat that. In Charles's defense, they were very frustrated after giving up six the last time on the field.
And frankly, it's just a battle of wills in a lot of ways, because you know they're both motivated, they both game plan for this drive, and they both have specific outcomes in mind. To me, it just comes down to who can execute better and which side can step up.
There he goes, right side. Loose inside the 30. And finally marked down at the 23. A big play there on the catch and run. 57 yards.
And the offense is saying to itself right now, only they were all this easy because he was wide open. And once he made the catch, plenty of room to work his way downfield. That was a breakdown on the defensive side of the ball, one that they want to fix immediately.
So barely time to catch our breath. Here's first and 10 just outside the red zone. McNabb to throw. And he's going to go down. They sack him back right around the 30. It'll be a loss of 7 on the sack, and it brings up second.
So a nice bounce back there defensively after giving up the big play.
Yeah, you can either get down on yourself or you can get motivated. And that time, they dropped him for a loss. So I would say that they got motivated and made the play.
Now it's McNabb.
And this one is going to be off the mark, too far out in front.
The touch and timing are critical for those types of throws. He put a lot of zip on that one. Needed just a little bit more finesse trying to get it to his back.
An incomplete pass on that last play, and that means they'll need to come up with something here on third down. McNabb. The open man is Westbrook. And that's not nearly going to be enough. Stopped at the 22, and he needed plenty more. That'll bring up fourth down. They wind up getting 8 yards, but they needed more than that.
And that's a play that's not uncommon on third and long, because the offense is just hoping that somehow they can get a guy in space and follow some blockers downfield. Does a pretty nice job there getting a few yards, but he ends up getting stopped before he can get the first down.
And the 10-year vet knocks it through the goalpost, and they take the lead here now at 10-7.
So they're able to end that drive with 3 points in this one-possession ball game.
And ideally, you want to end every drive with points. Most quarterbacks would tell you, let's end it with a kick, right? A PAT, that's number one. Field goal, you'll take. Punts, you really don't want to do that. In this case, they'll take the field goal and get prepared for the rest of the game.
The Eagle kick team out there now as they run up and send this one away.
And it'll come out to the 25 as he will not attempt to return. Dallas offense set for this next drive. A last series form, a little disappointing, forced to punt. And now they'll try to do better here and come away with some points as they begin this drive, first and 10.
Here on first down. That's going to be knocked away and incomplete.
Zone coverage there, and they were playing deep. That makes it obviously a little bit harder to run by guys. And that time, it was not much of a window to get the ball in there, and it winds up incomplete.
An incomplete pass leads to second and 10 from the 25. To throw is Romo. He finds his man, complete. It's Price. And they get him down, but not before he takes it across the 40-yard line. The catch and run there, good for 16 and a first.
And that's a more than acceptable read right there because it's zone coverage, so timing is everything. This time he waits for his man to come open, puts it right on him, and they pick up a first down.
Now a play fake, and it's Romo. And that went too far in front. He couldn't reel it in. It's incomplete.
He already came through for them on this drive. No surprise that they were hoping he could do it again.
An incomplete pass on first down. That leads to a second and 10. To the air again, Romo. Here, and that's complete. And he'll be brought down, losing yardage back at the 40. It'll go as a loss of a yard, so now they deal with third and 11.
And that was a heck of a play there on the outside.
Partner, sometimes I think on a play like this as a corner, you've got to think to yourself, all I've got to do is slow him down so others can come over and support. But in this case, he said, forget that. I've got this. Sorry you had to make the run for nothing, fellas.
Now a third down throw, but it misses the target, incomplete.
I'll tell you what, these last couple of drives, much better from a defensive perspective. They gave up a touchdown on the opening drive, and then after forcing a punt on their last possession, it looks like they're going to hit the football back again.
Out now comes the Cowboys punter, as he'll kick it away for the second time. And he didn't quite have the backspin on that one. It hits at the 4 and continues into the end zone. It's a touchback. Here's the Philadelphia offensive unit now as they head out to take over possession. And they split the uprights last time for 3. They've got the lead. They're not going to play this conservative. They're not hoping for another field goal. They're hoping for a touchdown.
I'm with you on that one. I like where your head is. I like the way you're thinking because you're exactly right. Trying to sit on a lead and play that way, that doesn't work too well for most teams. Run your offense. Yeah, run what you do best.
Put your foot on the gas.
Exactly. Put it all the way down and try to increase your lead in a big way. And the best way to do it, touchdowns.
A gain of 11 to kick off the drive, and it's a quick first down.
I think that's a big pickup for a first down because when you run a drag route against zone, you're sometimes asking for trouble because you might run into a defender.
Yeah, well, there they ran into a first down, executed it to perfection. On first down, it's McNabb. And that is incomplete here.
Oh, man, for him to be that wide open and drop it. Sometimes you have just too much time on your hands, right? You end up thinking way too much, and your hands get shaky.
And yes, he's a tight end, but that's a catch he should have made. Line of scrimmage, the 31 as they line up, second and 10. Up the middle they go.
Westbrook. And he'll get this to about the 34, a gain of just three. And hold on here, because on that last run, it looks like we have a player who was shaken up. While they come out and take a look at him, we will step aside for just a moment. Here's third and seven.
From the gun, here's McNabb.
Work in the middle of the field, and he's got a man complete. And he is going to have an Eagles first down as they're able to get the third down conversion.
And that's well executed there on third down, and I love the confidence that they had to let their tight end try and find some space in the middle of the field right in their quarterback's line of vision. And QBs love to make that easy throw, and they hooked up there for a first down.
From the midfield stripe, they'll look to throw. His throw incomplete.
Offense was moving it a little bit, had them back on their heels, but they earned a brief pause by forcing the incompletion. That gives them a quick chance to regroup and try and mount a stand before they're backed up even further.
So after the incompletion on first, now second and 10. They go play action. It's McNabb.
On the throw, let him too much that time. It's incomplete.
Oh boy, partner, did that just happen? I've got my hand over my eyes right now because like him, it's going to haunt my dreams too. He was wide open. How did he overthrow him there?
Defensively, just very lucky. You know that they got away with one there.
Here's McNabb.
Able to find the open man. That's complete. And he's going to have another first down here as the tackle's made at the Cowboys 33. 18 yards, a big pickup there on third down.
That's a play that'll likely be forgotten when you talk about big moments in this game. But plays like this are critical to keep drives going. And if points result, we'll call this play significant.
In motion left comes Brown.
Here's a fake on the jet sweep, and instead a give up the middle. And he works his way free all the way down to the outskirts of the red zone.
A good gain again. That's now 31 yards combined on those last two plays. Well, they're making an effort to get the ground game going tonight. So far, it's working.
I like what we're seeing from the offensive line. They seem to have the leverage going and are controlling things and reestablishing the line of scrimmage, moving that defensive front backwards, but also like what the runner's giving us too. It appears that he's been waiting all day long to get out here and take him.
Open man, he's got him. That's Smith for the Philadelphia touchdown.
A 20-yard touchdown.
And the Eagles are able to stretch out their lead.
And he is a reliable target. They like to get him involved. They got him involved there for the score.
And they should. He's a very good player. Remember, they can use him in certain positions, so many different spots, and he usually comes through for them.
Extra point attempt to follow here. It's good to make it 17-7. So that drive consumes nine plays all told. The result, Philadelphia in the end zone. Out is the kickoff unit as they run up and send this one away.
From a couple yards deep, he'll bring it out of the end zone. And only able to get this to the 19, so probably should have opted for the touchback.
Here's the Dallas offense now, heading back out onto the field.
Defense got the better of them last series, forcing a punt. See if they make a few changes in the game plan here and try to get points out of this drive. First and 10.
On the ground, it's Barber to start the drive. And he's going to get seven out of this before being taken down at the 27.
All right, so they got that one, Charles, against the center.
And let's remember how difficult it is for the center, because remember, he's got to snap the ball to put the play in motion. And sometimes you got that big guy on your nose. You got sometimes where he's coming at you at an angle. It's a difficult job for him to snap the ball and then execute his block.
They'll run with Barber here, right side. And he'll get this up to the 30-yard line. It's a gain of 16 in the Dallas first down.
A good run there off right tackle in an old-school NFL football. The right side, the offensive line, often known as the nasty side. The left side, usually the technical side. Kind of reminds me of the old Atlanta Falcons 2009-2010. That's how they constructed their offensive line.
Now a first down throw, Romo. Quick completion here to Johnson. And he gets this to the 35. Good for a gain of 5.
So, Charles, this defense, in for a tough matchup. What do you think the game plan is here tonight?
Well, I think the game plan is the same as most, which is, hey, pass rushers, do your job. Coverage guys, do your job. And the linebackers are going to be a mix. Sometimes they'll drop in coverage. Sometimes they'll pressure the quarterback. But all in all, you never want to let that quarterback get a string of completions going, because if so, they're hard to deal with, and it makes for a long evening.
7 yards there and a first down.
Well, that was a pretty favorable situation there. What would you call that, second and manageable? Smart play, too. Didn't force it downfield when he didn't have it. Just checked it down, let him get the first down, and that's exactly what he did.
Barber on first and 10, and he's going to take this ahead for right around 3 yards, but no more than that. Second down.
Not a huge carry there on first down, but not all of them will be. But still, all in all, a positive play for the offense. It's all about picking up at least a few to set up what you're going to do here on second down.
Here's second and 7. Play action. It's Romo. And he finds a man on the crossing route. And he has another first down as he'll get the ball down to the Eagles' 44-yard line. Give him 11 yards that time and a new set of downs. After one, 17-7 is our score. Start of the second quarter, and it's the Cowboys in possession, as they've got it with a first and 10. They'll fake the handoff. Now Romo. A throw left sideline, falls incomplete.
Well, a momentary speed bump there with that throw, partner. The defense had other ideas, and they're trying to mount a small stand before this drive reaches the end zone.
Here's second and 10. Off the RPO, he completes it. He'll get only 3 there, so it leaves him with a 3rd and 7 ahead.
The goal of a wide receiver screen is get enough blockers in front to create a wall and let him pick his spot to run the football. How about the defense there, swarming to it and not allowing that to happen? Did not let him get downfield.
The Cowboys on 3rd down, just 1 for 3 thus far. This is 3rd and 7. Romo throwing again. And that is incomplete.
And this defense definitely in his head there on 3rd down, and he's pretty fortunate. They didn't call for grounding on this one. That was a good 10 feet over everyone's head.
Out now comes the Cowboys punter as he's on to kick it away. He's been a busy man here in this first half as he gets it away. Philadelphia getting sent to take the field. They have to be pleased with the way that they've moved the football thus far.
And why wouldn't they be? 2 touchdowns on a field goal in their first 3 possessions. They're playing so well right now, the field goal probably feels like a disappointment.
On 1st and 10, McNabb. It's caught on the right side at Smith. And he'll get this up to the 30-yard line.
The drive starting with a first down, 11 yards on that pickup.
Good strong throw and catch right there. And so far in this game, the alleys have been open for them to get completions, and they're taking advantage of it.
So first and 10 now from the 30. A play fake. Now McNabb. This is caught. It's Brown. And he'll be taken down, but not before they work it across midfield. A good pickup there, 21 yards. So from Cowboy territory now, here's first and 10 at the 49-yard line. Now a handoff up the middle. Westbrook able to push his way through. And a 6-yard gain gets him right around the 43.
And hold on here, because on that last run, it looks like we have a player who was shaken up. Hopefully, obviously nothing serious here. Medical staff, though, going to take a peek, and we'll take a break. Line of scrimmage, the 43 on second and 4.
Out of the gun, McNabb. Throwing the out route incomplete. That's Lewis. And he's going to have another first down here as the tackle's made at the Cowboys 33. A gain of 10 as they look to add on to this 10-point lead.
But that's what you're looking for when you're wanting to throw the ball downfield. You want one of those guys who can play out on the perimeter, can play out wide, who can not only get open, but when they're covered, can uncover themselves downfield and create catches.
And they'll let the quarterback keep it here on first and 10.
And not much running room. Down to the 32. Only a yard on the keeper, and it'll be second down.
Anytime you decide to use your quarterback as a runner, most of the time when you design a play, you're expected to break a little bit bigger than this one, because when you run him on short gains, your risk reward and him taking hits, I'm not sure that's the payoff they were looking for.
To throw, McNabb. It's a short one here, complete to the tight end. And he's going to have another first down here as the tackle's made at the Cowboys 23. Give him 10 yards there as this offense is on a roll. This drive continues to plunge forward. Now a first down throw, McNabb. And a quick throw there is incomplete.
Yeah, their back's up against the wall a little bit, and they come through by forcing an incompletion. Now they've got to continue to ratchet up the intensity a couple of more times and get off the field before giving up any more yardage.
Now a second and 10. Now McNabb. This one complete to Smith. And he'll go out of bounds in the red zone just inside the 20. They get 7 out of that, so they're left with a 3rd and 3.
That's certainly one way to beat the blitz. Get out of your hands quickly and get it to the big fella.
Very effective. Saw the pressure, got rid of it, and the completion ensued. McNabb to throw.
He had a man open, but he missed him, and it's incomplete.
You've always been very good about checking my math. Am I correct? That's the first time that it's been incomplete when they've thrown it to him?
Yes, he had caught every other ball coming his way.
So they feel like they've got something really good going there, and they're going to continue to go there until the defense makes an adjustment and takes it away.
Well, they finally made an adjustment there. We'll see if they can build on that stop. And his kick is right there. It's good. And that will open the lead up now to 20-7.
So 3 points there, and they continue to build this first half lead.
Yeah, every little bit helps. And the more that you can put together drives and start controlling the tempo, controlling possession, finishing with points, the better off you're going to be.
Set now to kick this one away, and off it goes.
And here comes a return from just beyond the goal line.
powering his way forward. And they'll get him down right around the 25, actually the 26 officially, so a net gain of one there.
The offense for the Cowboys now working their way back onto the field.
And right now these guys, they're shuffling a little bit, maybe doubting, because three straight drives have ended with them punting the football away.
Yeah, so you start pointing fingers at each other a little bit, asking a lot of questions. What are you seeing? What are you getting? Maybe trying to narrow down your playbook a little bit and maybe get simpler rather than more complex in order to try and fashion together a drive.
Throwing on first down, but this one winds up to be incomplete. A misconnection there. He's hit on just 50% of his passes thus far. That's not where you want to be.
Now you see the evolution of the game. You go back to the quarterbacks of old, 50% would be terrific because they threw the ball downfield almost every time they threw it. Now with the short passing game, you should be above 60% just to be in the average range.
On second and 10, Romo. And this time he's got the hookup. It's complete. 9 yards, not quite enough, and they'll be left now with third and one. They'll try and run here with Barber. And he slips up past the 45 before being tackled. It's a gain of 12, and the Cowboys pick up the first.
Yeah, they really needed to get something going, didn't they? They had punted on the last two possessions. The running game starting to come to the front for them, providing a nice pickup there to keep this drive going.
On first down, Romo. And this is dropped. Oh, it's incomplete. He had a big gainer in his sights, but he could not reel it in.
And that is not what you expect from a receiver of his caliber. Sometimes you get a little ahead of yourself, you don't look it in, and all of a sudden it's on the ground. A surprise to all.
Up the middle they go with Barber. And a strong run that time as he's across midfield and down to the 43. 45 yards now on the ground on just 7 carries.
I'm okay with the call there. In fact, I actually like it. I know they're down a couple of scores, but the running game worked in that situation. I would continue to go in that direction.
So from Philadelphia territory now, here's a first and 10 at the 43. They'll stay on the ground with Barber and to the 36-yard line, taken down there after getting 8 yards.
That's a strong pickup right there on first down. And as this drive goes on, we're seeing an offensive line and running game imposing its will.
2 yards to go, second down. A run up the middle with Barber. And he gets it down to the 32. 4 yards the pickup, first down.
But we always talk about good down and distance allowing offenses to expand their playbook. Well, second and two, that means your playbook's wide open. You can run just about anything. But a lot of times, the play caller, he just looks down at his sheet, sees the short yardage runs, and goes to one of those.
They'll try the air now with Romo. Got his man complete over the middle. It's Johnson. It'll be a gain of 5, and it'll be second down. Romo. Throw left side here, complete to Campbell. And he's brought down at the 24 after a gain of 4.
Oh, it's time to give a little credit there to the defense. They played that very well because it was a drag route, and he ran it a little shallower than normal as he worked straight across the field. He was hoping he'd get lost behind the defensive line, but once he made the catch, nowhere to turn upfield and gain any yardage.
Meanwhile, on third down, they take a shot at the end zone, but it's incomplete.
They really had a good drive going there, but a nice recovery by the defense these past few downs, able to knock that one away on third down and bring up what I think for the offense, an unexpected fourth down here.
It would be a very makeable field goal try from here, but instead they're going to go for it. They'll try it now with Barber, and nowhere to go. He's going to be stopped behind the line.
He needed a couple, but he didn't even get back to the line of scrimmage. And this 11-play drive is going to lead to nothing on the scoreboard. And defensively, they were ready for that. A full-on blitz on fourth down, and they stop him short of the marker.
Oh, and someone's got to feel really good about that, and that's the defensive coordinator. He dialed up a great run blitz defense, and they hit it just right. Stack that thing up. They're going to feel awesome going to the bench after that big play.
Now it's McNabb. Throwing the out route incomplete. That's Lewis. And they'll get it up just short of the 45 at the 44. First play of the drive, a success, 19 yards. Took just one play to move all the way to the 44 as they try again on first down. Up the middle they go. Westbrook, and not a whole lot of room to operate there on the first down run. He gets maybe three.
Well, that's just a pile of bodies there, and that's when you kind of find out who's a tough guy, right? Who can stand up and make a play? It was only a three-yard run, but for both sides, they had to walk away from that feeling like, okay, I can stand up when the going gets tough in here.
On second down now, Westbrook, down the numbers, there he goes. And he takes this one down almost all the way to the 30. That's good for 21 yards and a first down.
We both know it's difficult, but they've made it look effortless out there. Through the air, on the ground, they've moved the ball with relative ease.
So from Cowboy territory now, here's first and 10 down at the 31. Now he'll try to run with this. And some determined running there as he'll pick his way down to the 12-yard line. Another big gainer that time. This one goes for 19 yards.
Well, I tell you, there is no antidote for speed, even at the quarterback position, as he keeps it himself and turns it into good yardage.
And it still takes time for a defender to react, even as quarterbacks carry the ball more and more in today's NFL. They're still a little bit in disbelief and realize, oh my goodness, he's running with the ball. He may be 8, 10, 12 yards downfield at that point.
On first down, it's McNabb. To the end zone, but it's incomplete.
As a corner, you have to be able to run with guys step for step downfield in man coverage and make up ground quickly in zone. You have to put yourself in position to make plays, just like that one we saw there.
Second and 10. Now a handoff up the middle. Westbrook showed off the toughness, but still corralled shy of the 5 at the 6.
67 yards rushing for him now in the ballgame.
A lot to praise on this drive, obviously. I know you're seeing what I'm seeing. Those guys up front, they're getting it done.
Doesn't matter what play is called. They are handling their business at the line of scrimmage and dominating right now on this drive.
McNabb. And that's going to be caught for an Eagles touchdown. From 6 yards away, as his guys have opened up a very comfortable lead. And all about timing there on that short slant, Charles.
Exactly right. That was timed up so well. The route, the throw, touchdown.
Now the extra point try forthcoming. And that one pushes the lead up to an even 20. So the drive winds up going 75 yards in 7 plays. And it was capped off by an Eagles touchdown. The Eagle kick team out there now as they run up and send this one away.
No run back here, down to a knee, and this drive will start at the 25.
A look at the running back, the man out of the backfield as he gears up to go again. And the ground game's been good, but they're losing here in the second quarter. Can they use that ground game maybe to work the air attack a little bit more?
I think so, because now you can throw play action off of being able to run the ball effectively. And oftentimes you might want to just swing your back out of the backfield and get the ball in his hands in open space. And just don't get totally away from running it, because some of these runs now, they may pop bigger as the game goes along.
Yeah, they've been good with a run so far. Now a dump off here complete. And from the 25, they work this to the 29, a gain of 4.
They'd love to just strike back with a touchdown right here. And if it's a long play, so be it. But the main goal, get a couple of first downs, run some plays, run some clock, allow their defense to get a chance to catch their breath, settle down, and relax a little bit after they just gave up a score.
Here's a handoff to Barber. And down right around the 32-yard line, 4 yards on the pickup.
On any running play that's called, they're always hoping that it's going to break big and go the distance. But when you get a nice gain like that, you're able to do so many things anyway. You can come back and run essentially the same play again, continue to move the ball on the ground, or you can decide to throw the ball now, because usually you have the defense back on its heels.
And we've hit the 2-minute mark in this first half of action. Here's 3rd and 3. Romo now to throw. And that is incomplete.
Whether that's a little grabbing, a little hand fighting, by any means necessary on 3rd down, he was able to get the job done in the secondary and swat that one away.
Out now comes the Cowboys punter as he's on here to punt it away. He's averaging just under 50 yards a punt as he gets this away. And a fair catch called for and made at the 12-yard line. 51 yards on the punt there. And the Eagles will be backed up deep to get the drive started as they take over 1st and 10. They'll come out throwing here to start the drive. The open man is Westbrook. And they'll get him down after a pickup of 8, 2nd and 2.
And a really nice play call there to start the drive, especially if you're a team that has a little bit of a reputation for throwing it downfield. You come out and you think maybe you can catch them off guard a little bit, and they did. Little screen pass, backdoored them, and that time worked well for a solid gain.
2nd down, McNabb. And he will go down, a Cowboys sack. Now the Cowboys going to burn the first of their timeouts as they'll head to the sideline and talk over what to do next. Third down and 13. Up the middle they go. Westbrook. And not much here as he'll get it to the 11, maybe the 12-yard line. The Cowboys going to use their 2nd timeout now as they'll head to the sideline and talk over what to do next. The Eagles send out their punter now, standing about a yard deep in his own end zone. And he'll take it just outside the 40. So a good punt there, but a nice return of 11 yards. And the Cowboys are going to take over in great position here with a 1st and 10. And now Dallas gets set to take the field.
And Charles, a very uninspired effort. The last time we saw them out there, it was a quick 3 and out, then they punted the football.
Yeah, and you never want to get stopped so soundly during a series, but what would be even worse now is letting it happen again right here. They've got to get going.
Now a 1st down throw, Romo. And he's going to get a solid gain of 9 before being brought down. Second and right at a yard.
They asked him to take charge and get them to a spot where they could at least attempt a kick before the half, and he does just that. Didn't trust what he saw downfield, so he took it upon himself to get them into field goal range using his legs. That's coming through with a play they needed in a big spot.
Now a play fake, and it's Romo. Oh, he's got a man wide open, complete. And he's brought down, but not before he reaches the 8-yard line. It'll go as an impressive 31-yard gain.
Well, as my dad would say sometimes, I'm just scratching my head here trying to figure out what was going on there defensively. How did you lose him in the middle of the field? If you're going to lose a receiver, make sure it's someone on the short side of things, not deep downfield, that can hurt your defense.
And with just 4 seconds left in this first half, a timeout call. So with 4 seconds to go in the half, here's the field goal unit onto the field. From the right hash here, should be an easy one. And his kick is indeed good, and that will move the deficit from 20 down to 17. Well, not the best first half facing this deficit, but at least they did put 3 on the board before half.
Yeah, it's a little bit like that stormy, cloudy day, and the sun peeks through just for a second. They saw the sun there. They're hoping to see a little bit more of it in the second half.
So barring a touchback, this likely the final act of the half as the kick is away. So we reach halftime in what's been a fairly one-sided game so far. As we send you on over to Orlando for Jonathan Coachman in our EA Sports Halftime Report. Take it away, Coach.
All right, Brandon, thanks very much. Welcome, everyone, to our brand-new studios here in downtown Orlando in the EA Sports Halftime Report. This was an extremely one-sided first half. One team showed up, ready to go. The other's been in a daze thus far, but there's still plenty of time left for this one to tighten up significantly.
All right, Coach, thanks very much. Fine work, as always, as we welcome you back for quarter number 3. So the Eagles with the lead, and they're going to get this football first as the third quarter gets underway. And he'll get it up across the 20 to the 21-yard line. The Eagles ready to go on offense to begin quarter number 3. And they've got the lead. CD, what do you think the message was at halftime?
I don't think the message was too drastic, I think, at the half, or that they need to change things too much. I do think the offensive line could play a little bit better. I think they'll try and help them out more. They'll probably keep a tight end in a few more times and maybe add a running back to the formation to pick up those pass rushers, because they probably allowed a few too many sacks for comfort in the first half.
And now a throw on first down there, but it's incomplete.
Oftentimes when you're losing a game and the team's still throwing with this kind of a lead, you start playing a little more physically. And they took that opportunity right there to be extremely physical and force that incompletion.
After the incomplete pass, here now is 2nd and 10. Now a handoff up the middle. Westbrook, and he'll get only a couple up to the 22.
Well, that's a good start to this drive on the defensive side of the ball.
And force the incompletion on first down. Then you're able to shut down the running play on second.
Yeah, I wouldn't be surprised now. A little bit of pressure going at the quarterback in the expected passing situation.
They'll be in search of 8 yards here as they hope to convert the first down. Here's McNabb.
And that's to the left sideline and incomplete.
Well, it's too early to figure out what kind of adjustments this defense made at halftime, but that's a good start to the second half. They cannot afford to give up more points and fall further behind, so well done to force the punting situation here.
The Eagles send out their punter now, as he'll punt it away for the second time. First kick, 47. This one looks good as well. Oh, nice move. A pretty good punt there, but also a nice return of 12 yards. And the Cowboys will take over the football with a first and 10. Now we take a glance at the offense as they work their way back out for their first possession of the second half. Good starting position for the Cowboys here as they come up first and 10 at their own 46. Romo now to throw it. And his throw here is incomplete.
Let's face it, if you want to get back into the game, these are the kind of throws you got to hit. He's wide open right there. Got to be able to get it to him, don't you think?
And those are the throws that haven't been available to them every time he's dropped a pass. Yeah, that's a big miss. So they'll come up after the incompletion for second down. Here's a toss play right, Barber. Trying to turn the corner, but he's going to be stopped right near the line of scrimmage. Officially nothing on that one, no gain, so they're left with still 10 to go on third down. He couldn't get the edge there, it wasn't sealed, so maybe not all on the guy running the football all the time on those tosses and the pitches that go to the outside.
No, not at all. I would agree with that totally, because sometimes the defensive guys, they win the edge battle, and when they do that, there's no place for the running back to go, and especially...
That's caught inside the 20! And he's brought down after a very nice game. On third and 10, they go flying past the marker and get nearly 40 yards. But look, you're not going to be able to get this all back at once, but that certainly helps.
So you're saying 3 yards in a cloud of dust, not the strategy?
I go aerial attack.
Yeah, I think that's what has to happen. And if you're going to run it, you need to break off big chunks. We just saw a big play right there. They need plenty of those.
So the big play means just like that, they'll operate from the red zone now on first down. To throw is Romo. Johnson with a completion over the middle. And the result here, a pickup of 8. Leaves him with 2 to go on second down. Ball on the 8, second and 2. On the handoff, this is Barber, and he is met in his tracks behind the line of scrimmage. He'll lose a yard on the play, so now they need 3 yards on third down. Continues to be a struggle for this offense, and this home crowd, they're growing a little restless here in the second half.
And I think they've just got to look at how they're trying to move the football. Yeah, you want to run it, but maybe you spread it out, maybe some swing passes that can take the place of runs and give you a little more space.
Now, here's a look for the end zone, but that one's going to wind up incomplete.
This has kind of been the story all night long, hasn't it? An inability to really get much done on third downs, and it's costing them.
So now on fourth down, Mike McCarthy will turn to his field goal unit. This is a 26-yard attempt. And this one is right through, and that will close the gap down to 14. So that maybe not exactly what they were hoping for, but it does get them back within a couple of scores.
And at this point in the third quarter, you don't have much margin for error, and that means you can't have drives that end with nothing. Whether it's a punt, a turnover on downs, those have to go away. You have to end with a kick, either a field goal or an extra point after a touchdown.
The kickoff team on the field now as they will send this one away. And this will not be returned. It'll come out to the 25. Here comes Eagle offense now as they get set to take over here. These guys definitely hoping for a better showing than their last appearance. They couldn't really even move the football much beyond the shadows of their own goalposts, Charles. We'll see if they can get a better, more sustained drive going here.
Yeah, and every team that we ever talk to says the exact same thing. When you start a drive from that deep in your own territory, the goal is a minimum of at least two first downs, because even if you have to punt then, you change the field position, right? You flip the field a little bit. They didn't get that done. This time they want to string together a nice drive and help themselves out.
Throwing there, but this pass is going to wind up incomplete.
His back has been a dependable safety valve all game, so he went back to him when his first read was covered. Just unable to connect, so the play results in no gain.
Following the incomplete pass, here they go again, second and 10 from the 25. They'll drop to throw. Over the middle here to Brown. And he's upended at the 33, following a good pickup of 8.
In today's football, where receivers break tackles, make people miss, get upfield for the extra yardage, when you see a play like that where it's caught and he's dropped on the spot, that's a big-time play by the defense.
On third down, Westbrook. And he'll be taken down, but he does have first down yardage. A gain of 4 that time as the drive continues.
Most of their damage has been done through the air. I mean, they've rung the bell 3 times with passing touchdowns, but guess what? Ground game has not been neglected. Nice little burst right there.
They show run with 3 tight ends here on first down. Brown goes in motion left. Now they show jet sweep, but instead a run up the middle here.
And he'll manage to pick up about 4. It's second down.
Well, on every play call, you realize it's not going to go for a touchdown, so a lot of your calls are setting things up for maybe later in the game, trying to establish the inside run. Run with us now, hopefully get to the perimeter later, and let's face it, you could do worse than a 4-yard run on first down.
On second down, Westbrook, and able to work about 5 yards out of this as he's taken down up near the 47.
Well, you certainly have to give a little credit here, because they're playing this game now at their pace. This is ball control football, sustained runs, taking their time, and making it work.
On third down, Westbrook. And he'll be taken down, but he does have first down yardage. It's a gain of 4 there, and it gives him a new set of downs.
I think they like this drive a little bit better there, partner. Running game helping out, picking up some of the slack. Because remember, the last drive, they went 3 and out.
From the midfield stripe, they'll look to throw. Looking left side, and he's got a man. That's Owens. Touchdown, Eagles! A great play there. 50 yards, and the Eagles take a 3-touchdown lead.
Well, partner, he has carried them in this ball game, throwing the football, all 4 touchdowns through the air, and that's really helped them get this nice lead.
And I know it's a team game, but right now, he is truly the focal point. Every touchdown his team has so far has been the result of his arm. How about him throwing it downfield, creating big plays? I don't know how you slow him down unless you can make him uncomfortable in the pocket.
Extra point splits the uprights, and the lead now to 3 touchdowns at 21.
The Eagle kick team out there now as they run up and send this one away.
And no thought to bring this one out. He'll just go down to a knee, and they'll take over at the 25.
Dallas offense set for this next drive. I kind of feel like they've reached a do-or-die point in this game, Charles. If they're going to try to pull off an impressive comeback, it has to start right here, right now.
Yeah, now they've got a final chance to get out of this situation, but they also understand they've got to move the ball and move it fast. In addition, they need to save as much time so they can get 2 more possessions.
They'll start out here with the option left. And he gets this one just shy of the 40, down at the 39. First play of the drive going for 14 and a first down.
It looked like almost a miscommunication defensively, because once he decided to keep it, he had pretty smooth sailing.
Yeah, it became a question of, wait a minute, who's got the quarterback? And when you talk about miscommunication, it's supposed to be called assignment football on the defensive side of the ball, but the assignment gets mixed up. That's the end result.
Here's a throw to his running back. It's complete. And they bring him to the ground just shy of midfield. Give him 10 there. Good enough for a Cowboy first down.
Well, they certainly had success throughout this contest getting him the ball in the passing game, and there he picks up another first down. Whatever they saw going into this one, they've been able to capitalize on it, and no adjustment has been made to take it away.
On first and 10, Romo. He's across midfield. And finally marked down at the 42-yard line. They had two straight first downs, now a gain of 9 to set up second and 1. Now it's Romo. This little short throw to Witten. No gain on the play. And now 1 yard to go on third down.
As a defense, you're more balanced when you're in zone coverage because you're able to keep your eyes on the quarterback and see the play develop in front of you. They're able to keep the quick pass in front of them and stop it right at the line of scrimmage.
This offense in desperate need of a conversion as they come up on third down. Here's Barber. And he's able to get the first before he's taken down at the 36. 64 yards rushing for him in the ball game now on 14 carries.
Yeah, once more, strong running, excellent blocking at the point of attack. They've got a nice little drive brewing right here.
So from the 36 now, first and 10. Here's Romo. And this is going to be incomplete.
At this point in the game and the situation they're in, partner, these incompletions that we're seeing, they need to turn into positive snaps, and soon.
So now second and 10 after the incompletion on first down. Back to throw, Romo. Throwing middle, and it's complete. And down right around the 32-yard line, 4 yards on the pickup.
They kept the receiver in the short field, but that let his quarterback get the ball quickly to him before either guy in double coverage could react.
Got to get to the 26 for a first. This is third down. Here's Romo. And this won't do it. He needed 6. He only got halfway there.
And partner, I would guess that in his headset, he was hearing from his coach, it's third down, don't take a sack. And in this case, he's able to avoid the pressure and get out of there. He doesn't get the first down, but he does turn a possible loss into positive yardage.
So now on fourth down, Mike McCarthy will turn to his field goal unit. From the left hash, this from 46. And this one is right down Broadway. And the deficit drops now from 21 down to 18. So his third field goal of the ball game brings him a bit closer, but there's no question they need to start turning some of these threes into sixes.
And sevens, and probably even eights. You know, as a kicker, you just head out when you're called upon, so he's done his job. It's the rest of the offense that needs to get it in gear. They want to close this gap.
The kick team out there for the Cowboys as they run up to send this one away. And he returns this to the 22. Eagles offense back out getting set for this next drive. And they'll just simply be looking to build off the confidence of the last time out where they scored a touchdown.
And confidence is powerful, isn't it? When you've scored once, you feel like you can go back out there and get it done again. Doesn't matter what the defense throws at them. They feel like they're in a groove right now, and they want to get out there and show it.
Yeah, hoping to stay in that groove here this go around. On first and 10, McNabb.
Oh, he rifles one, and that's going to be intercepted.
And his guys are going to take over at the 34-yard line.
Well, still down quite a bit here, several scores, but yeah, at least that's a start, Charles, getting the interception here. And look, we're still in the third quarter, so this thing not done yet.
You're right about that, Brandon. This defense, they haven't quit on this game. They stayed with it and got an interception and handed the ball back to their offense. And what you wonder about is the team that just threw that interception, they've got to be careful about developing a sense of complacency and thinking this game is over.
From the 34 now, here's first and 10. After the interception, here's Romo. And incomplete, a drop there in the middle third of the field. That'll bring up second down.
Well, defensively, you're over there trying to catch your breath and try not to show the offense that you're a little bit fatigued. You're right back out there after the turnover. Now they've got to work towards getting another couple of stops and forcing them into at least a long field goal situation.
Running with Barber out of the gun. And some strong running there as he's down just shy of the 20 on the edge of the red zone. 78 yards on the ground for him now as he's done that on 15 carries.
I don't know what this says about me, but I love successful runs up the middle when the blocking is so well executed like that.
And it doesn't matter whether it's zone blocking, whether it's a power scheme, when you have a blocker on a defender and then the running back can read it, find the proper hole, and just go, sometimes a thing of beauty.
And this will be a gain of 6 when it's all said and done. Down to the 15 from the 21.
Consecutive positive runs for him on the last two snaps. He certainly appears to be trying to put the offense on his back and just move them down the field when his number is called. The way he's running it, I'd keep going back to him.
To throw on second down is Romo. Johnson on its poke three. Football's held. And it's picked up by the Eagles. And a big turnover there as his guys will get the football back. Well, if these guys wanted to get back in this game, they needed an almost perfect second half. And down three scores, a lost fumble here certainly doesn't fit into that plan.
That reminds me of my plan in college to get an A on the papers I turned in, but that didn't work out too well either. Too many mistakes by both of us. I mean, that's just pure and simple. And that's why that's exactly where they are in this ball game. They're going to need a huge turnaround if they want to try and win this one.
They go back to the air here after the INT on the last drive. He's got a man complete. And he gets this one just shy of the 35 to the 34. That'll be marked as a 27-yard pickup.
This offensive game plan has just been sensational. I mean, when you think about all the different ways they've gotten their receivers open so far, it's really been impressive. Scheme, design, execution.
They run the option here on first and 10. And he tries to power forward, but he will not get back to the line of scrimmage. It's a loss of 4 there, bringing up second down.
I don't think there's any doubt that if it's me, I'd be really cautious about continuing to call this play, because you got to know, defenders, if they get a free shot at the QB, they want to take it, and they want to take it big.
And they got it there on the option play for a loss.
McNabb's throw complete there to Smith. Call it a gain of 6 on the play. And 3rd and 8 now.
The completion was given up, but that's why you play zone defense, so that you can have people around the ball when it's caught and you don't give up much run after the catch.
3rd and 8. Out of the gun, McNabb. And the Cowboys' pressure gets there this time for the sack. He couldn't get away there on 3rd down. The pressure too much, and he's sacked for a loss of 12.
Okay, I'm not sure you could actually draw up a better pass rush than that one right there. Nowhere to go outside. He had to keep backing up and backing up and backing up. Eventually dropped for a huge loss.
The Eagles send out their punter now as he'll come on to kick this one away. Fielded just inside the 30. Nice punt, but good work on the return to get back 11 yards. And they will take over first and 10. And this should be the final play before the quarter ends. On first down, it's Romo. And he will find his man on the end route, complete. And he'll go down, and that will do it for the third quarter of action. One quarter remains here on a Sunday night. We'll return with more after this break. You're watching the NFL on EA Sports. Back now in Arlington. It's the Cowboys in possession of the football, but they trail here as we begin the fourth quarter of play. Now Tony Romo on first down. He'll check this one down to Barber. So give him 2 yards there on the completion, and that's going to bring up second down. You got the big lead defensively. Willing to give him that underneath stuff, right?
And this is why you work on your tackling. Tackle him after the catch, inbounds, keep the clock running. Just go ahead and bleed the game out that way.
Romo. And this is caught by Witten, the tight end. That one, a gain of 20 and a first down.
Well, I can put my defensive cap on right now, and I know they're saying don't give up any big plays now. They've controlled this game throughout, and all they want to do is see it through to the end. I think they let their guard down a little bit with that last completion. Sometimes when you're trying not to give up bigger plays, you don't react as fast as you should on other throws.
Now a first down carry by Jones. And this will be a gain of 6 when it's all said and done. Down to the 15 from the 21.
That play wasn't quite as big as the play that preceded it, but still, gotta like the way they're moving the football, partner.
Absolutely. Pretty good room to run on that last play.
Yeah, they didn't get a first down, but still, you'll take runs like that each and every time, won't you?
Here's Romo now on second down. This one swung out here to Jones. And he'll get him inside the 15 down to the 14-yard line. Just a gain of a couple there. And now it's 3rd and 3.
And that's a good job there by the corner. And we do talk about this a lot, that a lot of corners see their job as simply covering receivers. Tackling isn't everyone's thing. But in this case, he came up quickly and made a nice, short tackle.
And all the way down inside the 5 to the 4. They're able to convert on 3rd down, and that sets up a 1st and goal.
Despite the score, despite the deficit, no quitting this guy. He's running angry, running through arm tackles. He wants to change what that scoreboard is saying.
1st and goal, and they got to be thinking a chance to get right back into this football game. Now Romo. Touchdown, Cowboys, from 4 yards out. And the Cowboys have got it back to a 2-score game here in the 4th. So a little bit of a letdown there defensively. I mean, look, you're still 2 scores to the good, CD, but things may be a little more uncomfortable than they had hoped.
Yeah, if you'd kept them out of the end zone there, this game's over. You've locked the door on them. Instead, it's still open a little bit, and they've got a puncher's chance.
Point after, right down the middle. And that'll make this now an 11-point deficit.
The kickoff unit is out on the field, and they will send this one away.
From a yard or two deep, here comes a return.
And just shedding him off there.
And no chance to get away as they'll get him down at about the 17-yard line.
The Eagles offense now, they head back on the field.
If they can score here, they have a chance to make this a three-possession game and all but put things to bed.
Now a first down throw, McNabb. Complete, this is Lewis. And he's got it past the 30 before he's hit and dropped. That play going for 16 yards to start the drive, first down.
Well, normally you might say start running the football, you've got the lead here in the fourth quarter, but the way that they've passed it with such success, I don't know, maybe keep throwing it.
Yeah, I think you brought up something that goes against conventional wisdom, right? In this stage of the game, you would think you would switch to a running attack, but you're exactly right. They've thrown it so well throughout the game, and trusting this quarterback, I think you continue to do so.
2 yards on the pickup there. It'll be second and 8. This defense starting to buckle down when they need to, and right now they're winning this fourth quarter, losing the game, but they're winning in the fourth quarter.
And what a fine line it is about what they're trying to get done, because they're down, so they obviously need the football, need a score, but they can't be so aggressive as to give up their edge, their gaps, and have the offense hit them with a big play.
2 runs in a row, but only 2 yards to show for it.
As usual, the hallmark of a good run defense, linebackers making plays near the line of scrimmage. Absolutely nowhere to run there.
The offense on third down tonight, they've hit on half of them, 5 for 10. This is 3rd and 8. Now McNabb. And it's knocked away and incomplete.
Going for the knockout blow right there. I think if I'm up 2 scores, I'd be worried about an interception, but playing this way is what got them this lead. So you may as well ride it out to the end.
The Eagles send out their punter now as he's on to punt for the 4th time tonight. That'll go as a punt of 32 yards.
And it will be 1st and 10 as they take over.
And now here come the Cowboys.
Well, still a long way to go, but trending upward. They scored the last time out, you remember. Then their defense forced the punt. Now they try to inch closer, but still ultimately down 2 scores in the final quarter.
So they'll come up 1st and 10 now from the 33. They'll start this drive out on the ground. And he'll take this ahead for about 4. 2nd down coming up.
Well, at the end of all that hitting and hollering, it was a 4-yard run, so the offense is going to go back to huddle and feel pretty good about themselves. Defensively, you have to feel okay because you didn't let it turn into a bigger run. But the goal, shut it down for 2 yards or less. That's when you start to feel good about yourselves.
On 2nd down, here's Romo. He finds his man, complete. That's Price. Give him a gain of 5 on the completion, and that will bring up 3rd and 1.
When you see zone defense and you know you've got a drag route on as your primary call, you've got to be really careful as a passer about how far you let your guy go because he might wander into some tough coverage.
1 yard, all they need, but it's 3rd down.
Now it's Barber. And strong running there as he's across midfield and down to the 49. They picked up 5 yards last time. Now they double it and get 10 here. Now, yes, a 2-possession game, but a good chunk of time on the clock, so they have the ability still there to run it on 2nd and short, but maybe they need to pick it up a bit.
You're right. They did pick up the 1st down there, but they, as you mentioned, they have to pick up the pace now because it's a 2-possession game. They've got to get there twice to make sure they have a chance to win.
And he gets this inside the 35-yard line. 15 more there, and they're on a roll. It's another 1st down.
That's a nice catch there. Remember, he had the fumble earlier. No way he was giving up the ball in that situation. Secured it tight to his body and picks up the 1st down.
I need more touchdowns!
A handoff left, Barber. And all the way inside the 15 before they drop it. Chewing up big yardage, another nice gain there. This one goes for 20.
What I continually hear from running backs and offensive linemen is how often they're actually getting together to watch film so they can get in sync with each other, understand blocking patterns better, how a running back likes to cut, what he wants to do. And boy, it all came together on that one.
That's one where they watch out and say, hey, we did everything we were supposed to do right there.
That looked like the play we drew up and designed. And then we got to see it unfold in real time.
Give him 5 on the carry there, and it'll be second down.
Hey, when you get good yardage like that on first down, it really does a whole lot of good for your entire offense. But I love the way he's finishing those runs. At the end of things, he's making sure he gets just a little bit extra.
Once again, it's Barber. And he'll take it into the end zone for a Cowboy touchdown. A great effort there with his second touchdown of the night. And the Cowboys have made it a one-score game again here in the fourth. Nice execution there. Good job by the O-line getting him in for the second time.
And you always have to start with credit there when you're having a big game. I mean, you don't get there by yourself. That's rare. But how about the ability to see the proper holes, pick the proper place to go, and find his way into the end zone?
It's caught at the one, but he will not get in here. He stopped up short of the goal line, and this will remain a 5-point game.
I don't know about you, but I can't wait for a few years of 2-point tries and see what the data tells us, because a lot of teams want to throw the ball in this situation, this time unsuccessfully. I just wonder if maybe running the ball might be the way to go.
With it moved up from the 3 to the 2, you would think maybe a few more attempts at running.
I think stats over time may bear out that running the ball will at least be the equal of throwing it in that situation.
A 5-point game now as here comes the kickoff. From a couple yards deep, he'll bring it out of the end zone. And able to get this across the 20, but not much further as he's dropped at the 23-yard line. The Eagles coming out as they get ready. Their lead back down to 1 score after the touchdown a moment ago. First down's a must on this drive as they start out here 1st and 10. McNabb to throw. And that one into the hands of Brown downfield. And he'll be taken down, but not before they work it across midfield. Give him 30 yards there.
Well, this game has certainly had no shortage of offense. Both teams have been revved up from the start. And here's yet another big play. Boy, both defenses have just got to be dragging out there because they've been run ragged throughout.
So the line of scrimmage moves all the way across the 50 now as they come up 1st and 10. Up the middle they go. Westbrook. And he'll get this down only to about the 46. Just a yard on the first down carry, so it's 2nd and 9.
Yeah, things were pretty stacked up there in the middle of the line. A lot of bodies, not much space. I think ultimately he was fortunate to get anything out of that run.
2nd and 9. Now it's McNabb. And this one incomplete. Too much contact to hold on to that one, and it's 3rd down.
Going with a dime look on defense. 2 extra defensive backs on the field and covered up essentially every blade of grass. That allowed them to disrupt the play.
And the line to gain here is the 37 on 3rd down. To throw, McNabb. And it's going to wind up incomplete.
The frustration evident there because he couldn't find anyone on 3rd down, and he left no doubt that he was throwing that one away.
So here we go.
Maybe the biggest kick of the game forthcoming. This to put him a touchdown and a two-point conversion up. And this one is no good. He missed it. And they'll be unable to build here onto their five-point lead. Well, this was still going to be a one-score game either way, but still, that's a potentially harmful miss here in the fourth.
It certainly is, because if you consider that now if they give up a touchdown, they give up the lead. So he might be getting the side eye, but a defender's coming out on the field now as he goes back to the bench after that miss.
The Dallas offense back out onto the field. Well, they didn't fall behind any further thanks to that missed field goal, but still staring at this fourth quarter deficit.
Now a first down throw, Romo. And it's incomplete. Boy, he doesn't drop many like that one. Second down.
In the early days of the NFL, you could easily blame these drops on maybe some uneven or uncertain lighting in a stadium. Not anymore. The lights are pretty good.
Yeah, they're great here at night, but his second drop indeed, not a good look.
Romo now to throw it. It's going to be incomplete.
They have to like what they've done defensively here at the outset of this drive. They forced a couple of incomplete passes, bring up a third and 10. Don't be surprised to bring a little pressure on this snap.
So back-to-back incompletions, and that has them staring at a third and 10.
Romo now to throw. He's got his target. That's complete. Touchdown! Big play there, 47 yards, and the Cowboys have taken a fourth quarter lead.
Well, quite the comeback here. They have erased that deficit, pushed themselves out in front now here in this fourth quarter.
Well, this game's kind of like a horse race, hasn't it, partner? Because, yeah, the other guys run out to their big lead, but then slowly and surely, they've been creeping up and closing that gap. Now they've stuck ahead in front here late in the game. The finish line's not far away. They need their defense to finish this thing off.
Romo gonna throw for it. That's caught. And he will not get there. He comes up short. And they're unable to push this lead to a field goal as it'll remain a one-point game. The kickoff unit as they run up and send this one away.
And there will not be a return here. It's a touchback, and it'll come out to the 25-yard line.
Here's the Philadelphia offensive unit now as they head out to take over possession.
We certainly have a good one on our hands. They're trailing after that last touchdown, but now a chance for this offense to try to snag that lead right back here in the fourth quarter.
Down, it's McNabb.
Throwing quickly there, but it's incomplete.
That was well defended. They clamped down on every available receiver. Just got to give the win to the defense on that snap.
An incomplete pass leads to second and 10 from the 25. Now a handoff up the middle.
Westbrook,
and he's upended after a gain of two out to the 27.
Pretty good little two-play sequence there. You force the incompletion, then a very short pickup.
Yeah, now maybe you bring in an extra defensive back or two because you want to try and defend on third down. They like to play those nickel or sub packages, don't they?
They'll see about converting this third and eight.
Here's McNeil. He's going deep for Brown. And unable to connect. Incomplete. Now give them credit. They took their shot, but it's going to bring up fourth down.
That was for the lead right there. They know they're in a position where fortune favors the brave. So they took their shot, but couldn't connect.
The Eagles send out their punter now, as he'll come on for his fifth kick of the night. And a fair catch taken back near about the 35, 36-yard line. Just 34 yards on the punt there, no return. And out will come the offense as they take over. Good starting field position for them here as they come up first and 10 at their 36-yard line. Although a jet sweep to start the drive. 5 yards is the tally on first down. That brings up second and 5.
But defensively, they had that one pretty well figured out.
Yeah, and one of the things about this play, it can be even more effective when you run a lot of motion. And there's plenty of times you don't hand it off.
Clock continuing to run. They'll probably wind this all the way before snapping it on second down. Romo. And this throw a bit late as he couldn't reach back for it.
They always say that real estate is about location. Well, guess what? When it's a slant route, the quick ones, timing, timing, timing. Got to be able to lead your man with the football.
And the timing off right there, threw it behind him. They come up now, 3rd and 5, following the incomplete pass. Here's Romo. Pass taken in by his big tight end. And he'll take this to the other side of midfield before going out of bounds. His fifth catch tonight, and it's good for a first down. He's been the go-to guy. They needed a big play there on third down. Went his way, it worked out.
Doesn't matter whether they scouted it or that they think he's going to get the ball. He has a knack for finding his way open and completing the connection.
On first down, Romo. Here's Johnson with a reception. And they're able to work this to the 25 before it's all said and done. Call that a very strong gain of 24.
These guys are running offense like you drive. The pedal is down, stomped down. How about that? Back-to-back completions, they are rolling.
So much for being conservative and running that football. Throwing again is Romo. This will be dumped off to Barber. The completion, but they go in the wrong direction. A loss of yards, and now they're dealing with a second and long.
I really like the angles that the tacklers came from on that play. They secured inside, took away the cutback. The sideline's there, so you can only go so far outside, and they were able to close in and tackle him for a loss.
Yeah, they used your boy over there, the 12th man. Sammy sideline, right?
Sammy sideline. You know something? He tackles pretty well, too.
He's tougher than an airport state. And they're knocking on the door now. There's a good run there. Going to take this to about the 10-yard line. This defense, Charles, they have unraveled here in the fourth.
In a sense, it's like they're being pressed, like in a basketball game, and they just can't get the ball over half court. I mean, no matter what they do, they can't get off the field. They can't slow them down. They're just going up and down the field against them. Yeah, unraveling would be a perfect word for them.
So first and goal, 6 points here would go a long way toward wrapping this one up. Here's Barber. And finding room to work, he's down to the 2-yard line. And now right out of the 2-minute break, we'll get a timeout used defensively with 1:56 to go. So they come up on second down, and they can get another run like we just saw, would likely put an end to this thing. Barber is in. Touchdown, Dallas. And he keeps carrying the ball into the end zone, and in this one, he's sort of carrying the team on his back.
He's the reason that they lead right now, no question about it. And you talk about on his back, he's not minding the extra weight at all, is he? carrying that just as lightly as he does the football. Yeah, what a great performance so far.
Those three touchdowns, it's got him in the lead. Still an important piece of business to take care of, the extra point. And with that, the lead is up to 8. So that drive takes him down the field in 8 plays. And it's culminated by a 2-yard touchdown run. Set now to kick this one away, and off it goes. And here comes a return from just beyond the goal line. And he'll take it a yard or so past the 20, call it the 21. So now the Eagles down by 8, a little under a minute 50 remaining. And no other way to say it, they have blown a big lead, but a chance to rescue things late. To throw. And it's a short one here, complete to his tight end. And he gets this up just shy of the 30 to the 29 before he's out of bounds. First play of the drive in their hip pocket. Of course, the focus here has to be the touchdown and the 2-point conversion. Field goals aren't going to help you.
Yeah, but how about that first play of the drive? Just to get them started. Nice gain, got some positive momentum going. They're on their way, and they don't have to rush.
He'll look to throw. Looking middle, and it's incomplete. There have been quite a few plays they might look back on and say, we really have hurt ourselves, and that was another example.
And this is late game execution. Everything on the line, so it all has to come together properly. The throw's made. Where's the catch? Got to catch in that spot.
They'll look to throw. He finds his man, complete. That's Owens. Now the Eagles will use the second of their timeouts as they stop it prior to what will be an important fourth down. Who wants it more? This is fourth and a yard. Gotta try it here. He's back to throw. They'll get this one into the hands of Lewis. They keep the game alive, at least for the moment, as it's a first down. Obviously a big first down right there.
Yeah, they still got to hustle. They got to get up to the line of scrimmage and get set. But I don't think necessarily you need to spike it, but they've got to continue to move quickly.
Just the one timeout remaining as they try to navigate this two-minute drill. First and 10.
Here's a throw to his running back. It's complete. And able to get this one across the 45 before he's brought down.
Short gain, last two plays. Who do you think's excited about that?
Absolutely, this defense. They're saying go right ahead with Oates.
Here's first down.
He's back to throw. He's got Lewis.
Partner, you gotta like what they're doing right there. Little by little, they're getting closer. Another good pickup.
Now second down and a few inches.
Back to throw.
This ball tipped and it's going to be incomplete. Fortunate maybe to get that back. It's third down.
This pass rush, they've been excellent all game long, and another example of it right there in the closing moment.
Not only with the pass rush, but how well they're coached, because if you don't quite get there, get to the quarterback, get your hands up into the passing lane and knock it away as we just saw there.
McNabb. And it is caught. The Eagles will take their third and final timeout as they get it with just 19 seconds left on the clock.
This offense cannot stop the clock now. No timeouts remaining as they come up here first down. Over the middle, that's caught by Owens. And he's taken down, but not before reaching the 10-yard line.
What a thrilling fourth quarter this one was. Well, at least, I guess, if you're cheering for the winning side, an outstanding comeback, though, that saw them completely take control and change the outcome of this game.
Yeah, I'm not sure how many of us saw that coming, the way that they were playing and having the lead after three quarters. A little bit of a stunning ending because it wasn't just a one-touchdown swing. It was a multiple-touchdown swing for them to end up losing that ball game. Give credit where credit is due. They came off the pace and got it done.
So that's a wrap for Charles Davis. I'm Brandon Gunn, and this has been a presentation of the NFL on EA Sports. For more, check us out at easports.com. It's a win for the Cowboys as we sign off and say so long from Arlington.